Hi, my name is Ellen, and I'm the Education Coordinator here at the Land Trust for Tennessee. Today, I'm standing in front of the beehives at Glen, Leven Farm. We're going to be taking a closer look inside of the hives and learning about our favorite friends, the honeybee. Now, I know you might be thinking, bees are kind of scary, they buzz and they can sting you, and that hurts. But bees really do their best to avoid stinging you if at all possible. They're usually pretty calm, so it's best if you can stay calm also. You'll notice that today when we go into the hives, we do wear some protection. That's just to make sure that the bees don't get trapped in our clothes or hair or in our faces while we're going into the hives. Let's get a closer look inside. Jack is our Glen Leven farm steward, and today he will be going into the hive to check on the bees. Before he opens it up, he'll give a little knock on the door using a smoker. The smoke calms them down and lets them know that he is about to take the lid off. Inside of the hive, you can see several wooden frames. Beekeepers put these in a hive so that the bees have a place to build their comb. As we pull a frame out, you can see that the comb is made up of tiny cells in the shape of a hexagon. A hexagon is a shape with six sides. On this comb, you can see brood cells, which is where the queen bee has laid eggs that will grow into new bees. In some of the other cells, there is honey that the bees will store up so they have something to eat throughout winter. If they make enough by the fall, beekeepers can harvest some of the extra. Yum! Bees have different jobs in the hive. Worker bees are the bees that go out and look for flowers so they can collect nectar and bring it back to make honey. While the worker bees are collecting nectar from flowers, they're doing something else really important called pollination. When a bee lands on a flower, it uses its straw-like tongue to draw out the nectar. While they're doing that, there's pollen from that flower that gets stuck on the tiny hairs of their legs. As that bee flies from flower to flower to flower, that pollen is picked up and dropped off at all those different flowers. Pollination allows those plants to grow new plants and also produce the food that we eat. Pollinators like honeybees are so important. Without them, we wouldn't have a third of the food that we eat. If you're interested in learning more about pollination, check out the link below for a fun activity you can do at home. I hope you enjoyed learning about our honeybees today. We'll see you next time.